still beating itself to death. My heart struggles to breathe a decent breath and restart. He who lets his true love depart is really doomed to relive his suffering through art. Or should I say, compelled to pick it apart. And if I were asked to describe to the youth the arrogant sloth that led to the terror and shock of confronting two separate futures that should have been paired up and locked, I'd say I don't care, I forgot. Nothing I could say could prepare you to rot in solitude, cause that's life. Doesn't really matter if it's fair or it's not. Well, it's been a long time since I was your dream boy street rat, playing at Cafe Biat for free drinks while you relaxed. My, how the years have elapsed. Smoking weed back in the old stairwell, how we'd laugh. Cause that was back when the air was clear, we could look each other in the eye before all we shared was fear. That was when you used to hop on the back of my bike to ride like a white trash princess to get a snack that you liked while I was outside packing a pipe. And then we'd hit the park to get high in a tree. All I liked it was you, and all you liked it was me. We worked hard, but life was just free, and I can just see us now lost in time on a bike ride through eternity. But in this timeline, things got pretty fucking dark and fucking unbelievably horrible. You fucking whore, you know even an oracle couldn't have foreseen how low your floor kept going. I've forlorn and grown in my aborted home, lamenting your ghost alone, trying to use ink like cortisone. And now I'll never be the same, I'm carrying the shame. I'm married to the game of washing off your name and burying the bones and carrying back home the scariest the poems, staring them alone. And the candle blows out and icy lips start to moan the name of the only love I've ever known.